The Warsaw Security Forum, which ran from November 8th through the 9th, presented serious revelations. The president of Georgia, Georgi Margvelashvili, insisted Europe must admit that Russian aggression is a security threat to the entire continent. He said that his country has been fighting a hybrid war with Russia since the 90s, and the situation is being repeated in Ukraine today.
2014, right now, starting from 2014, hybrid war in Ukraine. Was it new? No, this was the case from beginning of 90s where Russia's direct engagement was a factor to alienate and occupy two territories of Georgia. Very often I hear the comment that it was happening in 2008. No, the occupation of these two regions that are now currently occupied by Russia happened in the beginning of 90s. And the reason was clear. Georgia decided to be free and independent, to have its own choice, and it was punished through a hybrid war.
Within NATO, it is believed that alliance countries should not just fortify their borders, but also increase infrastructure through the entirety of Europe. At the moment, the continent is considered unprepared for quickly transferring troops and military equipment. NATO officials say that in order to modernize and secure NATO member countries, an annual minimum payment of 2% of each country's GDP is needed. So far, just a handful of governments have fulfilled this goal.
And as I said, 2% when you're facing a threat of a potential invasion, as you are, let's face it, as you are in Poland, as you are in Latvia, as, you know, some of the other Baltic states are. 2% is not enough. I mean, look at Greece and Turkey. They're spending, you know, 4-5%. So yes, things are moving in the right direction, but we've got a long way to go.
Polish experts believe that the policy of non-interference comes at the cost of EU border stability. They believe that the war in Ukraine's east makes dealing with Russian aggression much more difficult.
For 3 years, Ukraine has been fighting war against Russian aggression, and it does influence the security of Europe, security of European Union, security of particular European Union states, and it is completely naive to believe that we may just decide that some topics are not in our interest, we may easily avoid them, and we may succeed with a policy which is limited only to particular fields where we feel comfortable with.
All members of the forum agreed on one point. For the stability and security of Europe, common effort is vital. Increasing cooperation between the EU and NATO and assisting Eastern partners will create a more secure force against external threats.